Okay, so this is a PinePhone Pro running Arch Linux, and I'm going to go through setting up a few things, updating the phone, just along for the ride. First of all, I connected it to my Wi-Fi up here, and I need to figure out what the IP address is. So we'll open up a terminal and go IP space address. Okay, so that's 213. And we'll hold on to that for a second. I need to turn on SSH so I can use this guy. So we'll do a sudo. We'll do these commands here. Bring them up in the window so you can see them. Let's just do a start. And it'd be a minus. Okay, the password. Okay, so now we should be able to SSH. And the user is alarm. Okay, so now we're just going to run the terminal over here, and we can close out of this one now. Ultimately, we want to enable SSH, so I don't have to do this again. Alright, and then the next thing we want to do is I want to actually change the password. So we'll show you how to change the password next. And so we'll do this. Control C to exit. So now if I actually exit the SSH, the password will be the new one. And if we lock the screen here real quick, I want to unlock it. And that's okay, so it'll be great. Alright, so next thing we want to do is I'm going to change. So underneath, I want to get rid of this show all apps button down here at the bottom, this guy. Okay, so ultimately if I did this, we have an off and an on, so we'll come back over here in this. To turn it off, you do this to turn it back on. So we'll just paste this in here, and now you see that the that button's gone, which is great. Okay, the next I want to do is actually want to change the scaling, but I actually want it to start the next time we do this. So ultimately, we're going to do these commands. Come back over here where you can see this. So the screen scaling, and we're going to follow these ones down here. So we're going to make a directory fosh. We're going to copy that file over, and then we're going to edit that file, and we want to edit this guy here, right? The output scale 2 on comment both of those, and I'm a fan of 1.4. We'll write that out. And now when we if we actually reboot the phone, okay, so right now, right, the scale's big, and we will reboot the phone real quick and show you what that does. Okay, so now the scale is actually a lot smaller, which is what I'm after. Alright, that's what I want to see. Alright, so now we need to update. So ultimately, the update is going to be along the lines of we'll bring this up a little bit. So ultimately, we want to do a okay, so on initial startup, we may actually have to do these two. Typically in Arch, you need to do these two. Let's not do that one. Okay, so we want to initiate, and then we want to populate. Okay, then we want to do a pseudo Pac-Man minus SYU. That's what we're going to do next. Let's see, GNOME console, yes. Yes. Okay, so there's a whole lot of packages we need to update. So ultimately, the big ones we need to look at. Let's see. There should be. There's going to be a Linux kernel in here. There's a UPower, UBoot tools. Okay, we'll just do them all and see what happens. Now, man. So, another thing I like to do is I like to actually change change the download. So there's a line here, parallel downloads, so we can actually get more of them at the same time. I have a feeling my database is going to be locked. We have a problem. Okay, now we're downloading multiple at the same time. All right. Okay, that's done. Let's go get that. This one, parallel downloads. Okay, so we got that one for later in the comments. Alright, and we will reboot the phone and see what happens. Back up. It's really bright. I don't know why the brightness went all the way up. Can you guys see that? Okay. Alright. Let's go look for something. It's 10, clock's right. Okay. So, ultimately, now I want to go through some packages that I want. This command will clean up any unused packages. Okay, so that removed packages I don't use. Alright, next thing we want to do is I need to mount a network drive for local. Yeah, I need to make the folder first. So ultimately, I'm gonna use these commands here because I like to mount everything in the network, and then ultimately you're gonna use the pretty much the mount tsifs ... kind of thing, which I'm not gonna put for you guys. Okay, so now I should have a network folder. Yes, all right. So ultimately, I build packages, and I do have a custom database, but we'll get there here in a minute. So then what I want is, we'll get back to the network here in a minute. I want to install some packages. So my favorite list of packages will be gedit. I really like gedit. And as we install these, you should see them pop up on the phone if I can keep it unlocked long enough. So as we install it, see it's right here? There's the gedit. Okay. PCmanFM, I love that file manager. Okay. It turned into GTK3. Okay, so that popped up this typical key. Oh, but I don't like that one. Okay, so ultimately, I want to copy over. So I want to copy over some images. We'll get to that in a minute. So ultimately, when you open this one, if we actually go through some viewing options. Let's make our live flow easier. Okay. Let me go back. Darn it, I'm all over the place. We did this one, and we did Gedit. Okay, so, alright, so I'm going to install a couple custom packages. These are ones that I've actually compiled and have locally. And so ultimately I got to add it to the Pac-Man. Okay, so ultimately, everything that I'm going to do is local, so I'll put this down in the link, but there's the wiki page, so we're going to open that, and at the bottom, I'm going to always add this, so let's go down to the bottom. Okay, so there's a custom, that's fine, and we want this one instead. Okay, so now if we do another Pac-Man, we'll have a custom database now. Ultimately, now I can install a VNC viewer. Okay, so we should find this one now on my custom, which is I downloaded it off the so here are the options for that. This is how I build it, ultimately. These are the commands I do to build it. So we'll install that. Ultimately, if we run a that locally, and then if I have another terminal open and it's on my computer and I need to run that program, and we can connect to connect to it. Now we have a VNC viewer. So you have the live view. We'll keep up and maybe trim it off a little bit. And then we'll have the actual what you guys can see. Now you can see it a lot better. Okay. So in let's see, let's go back to gedit real quick. Okay, so if you install, I didn't open another terminal. Okay, back into the phone so we can see what's going on. You need to install Aspel and Aspel in your language. What that'll do is in Gmail and Gedit, right? You have something and you just type it. Okay, we'll leave that open for a second. So ultimately, there's no squigglies. But now that we have Aspel installed, let's see, close without saving. Go back in there. Paste the words. So in settings, let's see, preferences. Yep. It's plug-in. Spell checker's great. Okay, so we go back and then we go tools, highlight misspelled words. Now it'll actually have an underline. This also works with things like your chatty. I know we don't have a conversation going yet, but it'll actually spell check in chatty and a few of the other apps. It'll tell you that you're misspelling stuff. Okay, so back to, so ultimately when we install those, see, let's go back to gedit. So we did that quickly after. Let's see, what else do we want? GNOME screenshot is a good one. Okay, so GNOME screenshot is I think did I lose it? Counter contacts, console disks. There you go, screenshot. So you open this guy up, and I set a delay of 2 seconds, and I take the screen, and you can click the screen. Bam! And you can save it in your pictures. Great. Okay, so screenshots are great. I think the new Fosh is coming out with a screenshot button on the side. Okay, let's keep going here. The next thing is the file manager. I love this. It can actually, if we do a couple quick settings, so I like, let's see, folder view, I like details, yes, and I want this gone, so toolbar, so you don't have to set these once. I don't think. Okay, so display, that's all fine. Read backups, okay, layout. That's fine. So there's usually a double click. Change it to single click. Mount manual volumes. That's fine. That's fine. Advanced. Use default. Show only default menu. What I like to do, hidden files. Always show full file names. I like that one. Now Alt, Mount, Chill, Tab, Name, Medium, Change Folder, Advance. Oh yeah, I think we're good with those ones, so then we're gonna figure out how to click the OK button. Okay, so we should be able to one of these is the side pane, show the side pane. Okay, great. Let's go back to here and change this back to, that's nice. About 150, apply. Okay. Let's put that right on the screen. Okay. Alright. So now, if I actually get my thumb out, my finger, there's nothing going to be in here with a lot of files. But I do have a network I think I can browse that has a lot of stuff in it. Yeah, we need to set it to single click. Tools. I really think that was in preferences. Remove, erase all open files with a single click. Hey, okay, so single click with the finger and it opens. Okay, and it should actually scroll really nice too if we look at something that needs to scroll, like audiobooks. It'll actually scroll really nice with your finger. Okay, so big fan of this PC Man FM. I do not like the icon. So, let's go change the icon. That should be make another video of that. Should be in user share applications. Hey, yes, okay. Applications, and that's gonna be PC Man dot desktop. Enter. That's nice. Okay, so, oh dear, I'm forgetting about this. This is all okay. So, I'm going to change the name to just file. And I don't need any of these names. I don't need any of the other names. I think I wanted that one, but we'll see the other problem. Okay, and then there should be an icon? Yes, icon, system. I don't want the icon. I want a different. He just fell asleep. Okay, I want a different icon. I want an icon, and I want a logo. location to it. Okay, so I want to actually put, let's open up File Manager, this file, open. This is the icon, and so that would be icon equals /home/LARM/ SVG. We'll write that out, and it should automatically change. Yay, see that icon changed. Okay, now we're talking a little bit better. I thought, preserve, I don't want to preserve, I want detail list, and that's how I want it to always open. Well, that's fun. Okay, does that actually work? Hey, that's better. Okay. Alright. I think I'm going to call it a night. So any other videos or questions, I'll continue this in another episode. But thanks for watching, and if you got any comments, leave them down below.